So hello friends, welcome back, and in this video we are going to see problem A. So earlier we saw problem B, C, D1 and D2. So now problem A. So firstly the problem says that we have two players. The player name is Raze and Breach. So they are playing a match. We have n numbers, you can say a string of length n. So at like if I start with the odd index, like if I say that my indexing is from 1, so Raze will choose the odd index places and Breach can choose the even index places. Raze, he can remove any elements from those odd index places. Breach, he can also remove any elements from these even index places. Now at last, when one element remains, so if the last element remaining is an odd element, so I can say that the Raze has won. But if the last element remaining is an even element, so I can say that Breach has won. Now, as we know that both the players are very greedy, and especially Raze has started the game. So Raze, he can choose from the odd places. Now at odd places, we can have either even elements or odd elements, right? So Raze, as he know that he will win only when he will obtain an odd element in the last. So he will always try to finish the even elements before, which means that as Raze is starting, so if I for suppose say that, okay, that I have these places, right? So Raze will work only here, right? So Raze will always try to choose the even numbers from here, and he will try to reduce those numbers, which means he will try to remove those numbers, even numbers. Now for Breach, which means that if the number is even and odd, so Raze will always firstly remove the even number, right? Now for Breach, if, like, see, it's a Breach location. Now for Breach, if he has even and odd options, so firstly he will try to remove the odd one, because he know that if even remains in the last, only then he can win the game. But as we all know that in one step, if, like for Raze, if my even is not remaining, if my odd is only remaining, then he has to remove the odd one, right? So yeah, they have to remove like either even or odd. But always, if my, for Raze, like for Raze, if even is remaining, then he will always prefer to remove the even, and if it is not, after that he will prefer, like he will remove the odd. For Breach, firstly he will like opt to remove the, you know, odd, but if like if odd is not remaining, then he will remove the even one. Let's see the few example, by that it would be more clear. Let's take the last two example because they are bigger ones. Because see, in the first example, as you can see that 2 is the only element remaining, so Breach will win. Breach number is 2, so answer is 2. For the next case, my one number is 3, so 3 is odd, one number remaining, 3 odd, Raze will win. Raze number is 1. Very fine. Now I have three, like the length is 3. So element are 1, 0 and 2. As I know that the starting with the odd indexing, and next I have this. So it's for Raze place. Now Raze first turn is there. So he will always, as I said, he will always try to remove the odd one. Sorry, even one. So he will remove this even one. Now like the remaining one is Breach. Like Breach has only one element and he has to remove it, so he will remove this. Now the one number is remaining, right? But it is remaining odd, so Raze will win. Raze wins. Now let's take the next case where we have 4. So for 4, I have 2 0 6 9. Now Raze can operate here. So Raze, see, both are even, so Raze can remove anyone, so he will remove this one, let's suppose. Very fine. Then our case is for Breach. So Breach, he can also remove anyone, but as I said that he will always opt to remove the odd one, so he will remove the odd one. Very fine. Then the case is for Raze, he has one element remaining, no matter what it is, he has to remove it. He will remove this. Now one element remaining in the final array, which is even, so Breach will. Thus with the help of this, I can find out, okay, who will win. Now okay, it was the approach. Now how to implement this? Now see what I wanted my number of odd elements at odd location, number of even elements at odd location. Next thing I want is number of odd elements at even location and number of even elements at even location, which means that I need r odd, which means that for Raze, number of odd elements, and for Raze I mean the odd locations. I need r even for Raze, number of even elements, which means that for odd location, number of even elements. I will need b odd, which means for breach, number of odd elements, which means for even indexes, number of odd elements. I will need b even, number of even elements for breach, which means that number of even elements at the even indexes. So, but as you all know that I will take input in form of a string, and as I know that for a string, indexing is always started from 0 rather than 1. So the first index will be even. So for Raze, I was earlier saying that it is odd indexed, but as I am having the string in the form of a, as I'm having input in the form of a string, so it will be always starting with the even one. So the slight intuition, the slight change in the problem now comes is that for Raze, we will start with 0, and for breach, we will start with 1, which means for Raze, we will have even indexing, and for breach, we will have the odd indexing because I take input in the form of a string. Very fine, let's see the code pretty quickly. So firstly, I had my r even, r odd, b even, b odd, as I showed you the variables in the explanation also. Then I just find out that, okay, how many number of r evens would be there. And as I said that for Raze, my indexing is starting from 0. So for Raze, even indexing, which means I mod 2 is 0, then my Raze turns. So I will update my r even and r odd. For breach, I will update my b even and b odd. Then I have this start variable. Start will indicate that first turn is of Raze. After every turn, I will change the start, which means for start equal to 1, I will change the start equal to 0 for the next turn. For start equal to 0, I will change the start equal to 1 the next turn. Then if for Raze, for start equal to 1, which means for Raze, if my even is more, which means my even is still there, so I will try to decrease that even part. Then I will try to decrease the odd part. For breach, I will decrease the odd part first, and then I will decrease the even part. And yeah, as I said that I will change the state also, which means start from 1 to 0 and from 0 to 1. And as I said that I need one element in the last, so I will run this loop until my n is more than 1, and I will also decrease my n so that, yeah, my loop should not go infinite. Then at last, if my any even number remain, I can clearly say that my breach has 1. But if by anyhow my odd number remains, so I can see the Raze as well. So I hope that you guys have got the intuition and everything for this problem, and I hope that I was able to understand you. Although it was a pretty easy problem and nothing much in it, but yeah, we will meet you in the next problem with the next beautiful thing. And yeah, until then, be happy and keep coding. Bye.